students, we are going to solve exercise 1.6 of NCERT in this video. So the questions are written over here. Let's see. In first question, we are asked to find the value of this. So 64 is what? 64 is 8 square to the power 1 upon 2. And this you can write using this rule. A to the power m to the power n is equal to a to the power m into n. This rule should be used. So it becomes 8 to the power 2 into 1 by 2. 2 get cancelled. The outcome is what? 8. Similarly, 32 can be written as 2 to the power 5. If you will split up 32 using this concept of division, divide 32 by to make its factors, so you will find 2 to the power 5 whole to the power 1 by 5, which is same as 2 to the power 5 into 1 by 5 using the same rule, a to the power m into n, 2 into 1 by 2, 5 into 1 by 5. The outcome is what? The outcome is 2. And if you wish to simplify, then it will be very clear to you that it is 5 to the power 3 whole to the power 1 by 3. Again the same concept. So it was all about the question number 1, who had 3 parts. 9 to the power 3 by 2, you can write 9 as 3 square to the power 3 by 2. Use the same concept, 3 to the power 2 into 3 by 2, 2 get cancelled, this is 3 to the power 3. 3 to the power 3 you can calculate, it is 27. And similarly about 32, 32 is 2 to the power 5, whole to the power 2 by 5, it is 2 to the power 5 into 2 by 5, 5 cancel, 2 to the power 2. And 2 to the power 2 is 4. So your answer is 4. Now question number 3 of second question, you can see 16 you can write 2 to the power 4 whole to the power 3 by 4. And if you will use the same concept which we have used, your answer will be 8. This is a good question. 5 to the power 3 into to the power minus 1 by 3, 5 to the power 3, what is 5 to the power 3? 125 is 5 to the power 3, 3 into minus 1 by 3, so 3 get cancelled, plus into minus is minus, 5 to the power minus 1 means 1 upon 5 to the power 1, because a to the power minus m becomes 1 upon a to the power m. So its answer is clear to you now. Its answer is 1 upon 5. Let's discuss now question number 3. In question number 3, we are supposed to simplify. Since here bases are same, powers can be added. 2 to the power 3 by 5 plus 1 by 5, what rule we are using? We are using this kind of rule, a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n, and this is equal to 2 to the power 3 by 5 plus 1 by 5, which this is what? Denominators are same, numerators can be added directly. And here 1 to the power 7 upon 3 to the power 7. Which rule we have used here? A to the power m in upon b to the power m is same as a upon b whole to the power m. This rule we have used here. 1 to the power 7 is 1. 3 to the power 3 into 7. 3 into 7 is what? 21. So 1 by 3 to the power 21. What rule we have used? This rule, a to the power m whole to the power n is a to the power this m into n. And what about this? Bases are same. So this rule we will be using, a to the power m upon a to the power n is a to the power m minus n. So this is 11 to the power 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4. 1 by 2 you can write 2 by 4. Its equivalent form 2 by 4 minus 1 by 4 is 1 by 4. So your answer is 11 to the power 1 by 4. At the last, we have this question. So here bases are same, but powers are equal. So we will be using this rule, a to the power m into b to the power n, m, because powers are same, is a into b to the power m. So it will be what? It will be 7 into 8 whole to the power 1 by 2 is equal to 56 to the power 1 by 2. So it was all about this exercise, and I hope only 6 minutes we have taken to solve this. And if you individually solve this exercise, hardly 3 to 4 minutes you will take to solve. So my good wishes with you. Myself, Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi, your guide, your teacher, wish you all the best.